I suppose I'll find out whether it's worked properly when I go to hang it up on the wall. They might fall off. It wouldn't be fun. Oops, I don't think that's going to stick properly. I feel okay. I feel secure enough. This one's got a good surface to put glue on. I put too much then. Might have some sitting up on each other rather than flat. Pause and scratch my eyelid because it's itchy. Oh, not too hard though, or I'll split my skin, which happens quite easily with me. Because I've got delicate skin, I've split my eyelid skin quite a few times just by rubbing. I have to be careful. Of gaps. I can fill the gaps with smaller ones, that's all right. My mother called up before and she's going to come up on Friday, she's decided. Because she can stay overnight at a friend's place. Well, she's going to come up on Thursday, spend the night at her friend's place and visit with her, and then go visit another lady that she knows who's in a nursing home. And then on Friday, she'll come and spend the day with me before she heads back off, back to her place, which is about an hour and a half drive. Sometimes takes 2 hours if the traffic's heavy. So she doesn't come up all that often because it's a long trip for her. And although she says she doesn't mind, I think that would drive me crazy going back and forth that distance in the heavy traffic. And you've got to concentrate, and she's 80 years old, so. But she said she's fine with it. And I think I want that the other way. I'll have to redo that one. Wait till that glue cools down and I'll pull it off. car horn. I saw on Facebook a photo of the aftermath of the Hurricane Matthew. Gee, that was awful. Poor people. I can't imagine living through something like that. And the amount of destruction. And the photo I saw was a whole lot of seashells washed up on the shore. Some really beautiful shells, but I just think, oh, poor sea creatures. It's amazing to think that little creatures lived inside all these shells. little crabs and other things, weird things, I don't know, what lives in shells? Little mollusky creatures, I guess. I don't think that's stuck properly, no. Ugh, stuck to my fingers. Try that again. Ooh, too much glue. It fits all right in there. So hopefully this will look all right when I finish. It's just going to take a long time to get it done. That's the problem. I thought about what I've done before with shells is putting the gloss varnish on them, but I decided against it this time because I want them to have a more natural look rather than being all shiny. I'm probably going to use up the majority of the shells that I have on this canvas, so might need to get some more later, I don't know. I think about hopefully, you know, most of these shells are just that are washed up on the shore and not that people have caught and forced the poor creatures out of them, just so they can have some shells. Wouldn't surprise me if that goes on somewhere in the world, which is a bit cruel, really. Oh, come on, sit down. No, oh, it's gonna work. I'm gonna just put some glue down here. I've run out, have I? Yeah, I've got to put another stick in. Oops. Where was I? No, here. I forgot where I was. Go on, sit down. Oh, come on, get off. I'm all tangled up with glue strings. Some of the hessian sticking out, I think. Oh, what's that noise? Oh, I can hear a noise and I just realised it's my son's massage thing going again. Oh, come on. Work for me, please. I don't know where I want this now. teddy bear. Pretty texture on that side. Problem is, there's very little surface that touches the canvas to glue, so I'm going to have to do it this side, which is a shame, but it wouldn't work otherwise. My legs are starting to hurt. Oh gosh. My knees. I might just take a little break and sit down for a while. I'll be back soon. Alright, I'll keep going. Just put some in the gaps. Oh dear. Oops. Don't stick to my finger, stick to the shell. If I want that there. Maybe put that there. There goes our son sneezing with his hay fever. Oh, poor thing. Sometimes he'll sneeze for ages. I don't think I like that shell. Where's my tin again? Oops. The shell stuck to the thing. Don't know how that happened. I hadn't put any glue on it. There must have been some on the paper. Now, I think. Two little gap fillers. The little ones mostly are a white. I do pale. I wish I had some small darker ones. Oh, there's some. A little bit darker. Sorry if the noise is annoying. Oh, there's another one of those. There's some tiny ones. Oh, that's pretty, except it's broken. You see the pretty stripes on there? If I can slot that in somewhere. Yeah. So it doesn't matter if it's broken. That's a nice one. Keep that for something else. Tiny brown one. Ooh. Look at that one. I've forgotten what they're called. They're barnacles or something like that. Hmm. Interesting. That one's a funny shape. Doing in there. And there's a flat oyster type shell. I think it's too big for there. Alright, let's see what I can do with those. This one here. Ooh. I've got more glue on my finger than on the shell then. And it didn't sit down properly. Sit down. Sorry about my arm waving all over the place. I'm trying to get the glue strings off. That was stuck, that wasn't. Neither was that. Okay. Pretty, pretty shells. Oh, that went a bit wrong. Oh, don't stick to me. Get off. Oh. Might have to get in there with the tweezers after, I think, and pull all the glue strings out. Because it's very, very thin. That would go good there. just started to say something with beep. I was going to say, I think my hubby's going out again tonight with his camera to try and get some of the moon. What are they calling it? The super moon or something? He couldn't go out last night because it was raining too heavily. He got a few good shots from the previous night, but he wasn't happy with them. He's going to try again from a different angle. It'll be good. Good if his idea works. It'll look really nice. Harder with these smaller ones. Try and get the glue on and put them in place. Ow! Gee, my hands are dry. Did that work? Oh yeah, I thought it hadn't worked. Oh, what about a bigger one? Can't really see it there. I'll try this one. What did I say? That way. Decide something and then not even half a second later forget what you want, what you decided. That's crazy. Netting stuff just went straight underneath my thumbnail then. Ouch. That hurt. Oh, my knees. Put something up here. Hurting as well. Whinge, whinge, whinge. Sorry. Oh, I'll just stretch. Oh. I normally don't stand up for very long because it ends up hurting me a lot. But I have to for this as I can't see properly if I'm sitting down. Just have to take breaks and relieve my legs and back for a bit and then come back again. So I might do that now. Alright, back again. After having a rest. Is my glue gun still alright? Yeah. Good. Now, I think I might be almost done here. Maybe just put a couple of little bits. Few more bits. See if this is going to work. Oh, wrong way, wrong way. Sit down. That wasn't very successful. Try sitting up flat. My finger on the back of the canvas so I can press it in. That's alright. Maybe something on the side here. I'll just put some glue there. Oh, not too much. It's all right to have a few gaps because then you can see the stuff underneath. So I might leave that there. And then I'll pull the glue strings off later. Now what I think I might do is cut my mermaid out because I want to put her where I want her to go, just as a guide to what I want to put down the bottom. I might turn that around so I can work on the bottom and you can still see. It's difficult. Maybe if I turn it upside down. Might work. Have it like I had it before. Right, so I'm going to get my mermaid and I'll probably speed this up. You probably don't want to watch me cutting her out, or I might even do it off camera. I don't know. We'll see. Good morning. I'm back again. I don't know why, I feel a bit out of breath. Now, I was looking at this morning. It's all dry now and it's stayed on all right. I've got a bit of glue I need to pick off, but I'm thinking I don't like this sticking out by itself. So I've got a few other bits I might stick in under there just to balance it a bit. I might want that the other way. Something like that. Just so it doesn't look funny with one bit sticking out. Where's my glue? I have to do it sitting down today. I stood up for too long yesterday and I aggravated my back. And I had a not very pleasant night last night. A fair bit of pain. I've got two bulging discs in my lower spine. And for the most part, if I'm careful, it's okay. But if I stand up for too long, my back starts to really hurt. And silly me, I didn't think about that and I left it too long yesterday, so I paid for it later. So I'm going to take it easy and sit down today. Stick that with a bit of this glue. It should be alright, and it worked alright with the other one. Oh, the sun's come out again. It's been really miserable looking this morning. Cloudy and cold and windy. It's really yuck. Okay. So that can just dry by itself while I do the other end of the canvas. Just brush these fibers off. Turn this around. So hopefully that's in view. And then I'll start with more bits of, what's it called? We call it hessian. I'll start putting all of that down. Do I have a drink? Remember that it's very fluffy. I planned this out sort of roughly how I wanted it. It's hard doing it upside down too. I might have to turn it round. My poor little brain can't think. I'll show you in a minute while I get it set up. It's not anything special, it's just bits and pieces overlapping each other, but I wanted it in a particular way because of the way I want to lay out the shelves. There, so that's roughly it. So I'll do that with this glue again, I think. I don't really have much to tell you today. I'm a bit boring. I got up at 8 o'clock this morning. After Clyde woke me up barking in my face. He's telling me urgently, I want to go out. My hubby gets up super early. 5 o'clock-ish, it's way too early for me. So then the boys stay in sleeping with me. Sometimes they sleep until well beyond 10 o'clock and we're waiting for them to wake up. Because they have their, they get fed in the mornings, and they have a little snack at night, but they get their main meal in the morning. And particularly during winter in the colder mornings, they love to sleep in beyond 10 in the morning. But they're old boys, so they're allowed to. We certainly wouldn't be kicking them outside in the cold. So they get to stay inside and snuggle up and keep warm. As all good puppy dogs should. I don't suppose it really matters how these go down because they're going to be covered up quite a bit, but I like the idea of it being there. here next. Ooh, no. Look what I did. It should be okay. I cut out my mermaid last night before my back got bad enough that I had to lie completely flat. So that was a bit tricky trying to get through all the hair. So I'm glad I did it slowly and took my time and not on camera, because it would have taken ages. Just rubbing that glue off my fingers. That works. Push it down with the bottle. Just brush these off. They're a bit annoying, those fibers that come off. Little tiny things. Week. It's sort of busy week this week. I've got today's Tuesday. Tomorrow I have my visitor that comes once a week, and she'll take me for a walk, hopefully if the weather's good enough and if my back's okay. Just depends if I'm up to walking. So that's her on Wednesday, and then that'll pretty much wipe me out. I'll sleep a fair bit after she goes, and then I'll probably, when I wake up, I might do a little bit of video editing, and then it'll be time to do dinner, and then that's the day gone. Thursday I've got hospital appointment for a review with the dermatologists about the skin rash that I've got. So that's a 4-month review. So I saw them 4 months ago, and they were thinking back then that I probably wouldn't even need to come to this appointment, that everything would be fixed up and I'd be fine. But of course it's come back, and it's gradually increasing. It's still nowhere near as bad as it was, but I need to just go and speak to them and let them know what's going on and see if they can offer anything. And just so it'll be on my records for future reference if this continues to annoy me. I hope not, but sometimes you just got to live with whatever you get, don't you? Oh well, I'll just take it one step at a time, see how it goes, see if they can help me at all. They're probably not. I'm expecting that they'll probably just say keep using the cream and just manage it the best you can that way, which is what my GP has been saying. She says that she doubts that they'll ever be able to cure it 100%. Ooh, got a lot of glue on me. Let's wipe that on the paper. Sorry for the noise. Just wrap this off my hands. And I've still got one piece to do, haven't I? little piece. I hate that sticky feeling of glue. I like those shaggy bits hanging off the edge. Clean up time. I'll dry that off and then I'll come back.